here tonight from there, and we would come here and beat these guys in seven. It's pretty awesome. It's Father's Day weekend, and my dad Robert's here with me. It's pretty special. My grandma George is listening to home, so two pretty important people in my life, and without them, I wouldn't be here.
Yeah, legendary folks of the sport. And your buddy Trailer up there says 15 years ago, you seemed to be young. Now, maybe long in the tooth. He's got a little gas.
Well, I just, we're out dancing around here celebrating our AM races. We go to the gym so we can run races like that. And anytime Trailer wants to go on a foot race, I'll go anymore.
Says a lot to the caliber of talent before we let you go and celebrate. I know you're always a man to meet when you unload on the national tour in Knoxville, wherever you go, but the caliber of drivers you're running against when you show up with the ASCS.
Yeah, you know, Sam and, you know, Ian's a tough one there. We go out at night and night out. We're good friends, but we don't give each other an inch on the track. So there's 20 guys that can win here, and luckily we're the one. Just, I don't get back home in Mobley too often, but this is home, and thank all you guys for coming out. You guys are my fans, you're my loyal supporters, and we appreciate you guys coming out.
Welcome home, my friend. Ladies and gentlemen, Patrick Palmbrow, your winner tonight's stop number six on the Sizzling Summer Speed Week for Lucas Oil American Sprint Car Series. And this cat right here from the country of Australia, he has not been on the tour of the Speed Week with us all week long, but Ian Madsen, I tell you what, just like Brian Brown, when you unload, all of our guys have to step up their game as well tonight. And on a big old half mile where you kind of just had to hang in there until it got dicey, you fared well. A solid podium finish for you.
Yeah, it was a great night for our team. That 360 package is pretty awesome, and just kind of thank the whole KCP racing team enough for letting us come race here. And it's always great to come race with the Lucas Oil Series. Mobley's an awesome track. I wish we got to come here more often, but unfortunately we don't. So just want to thank all the fans for coming out and supporting them when we do. And great job out to Brian, Chad, and the whole team. They did a great job, and they're an awesome team. So it's awesome to be racing with them night in, night out, and it's good to come in and race with guys like Sam, too. And really good race.
These high banks here in Mobley, Missouri did not necessarily widen out until late in the race. Didn't even really widen out, but it took a while for it to get dicey and racy, but once it did, it was wild.
Yeah, I think you kind of got a late start on the racetrack after the sun went down, and it took a while for it to widen out, but in the feature race, it was you couldn't ask for any better, and it was just a great race with the top five guys there.
Always glad to have you with the ASCS. Welcome to the Show Me State of Missouri, and we'll see you real soon up there at Berry County Fairgrounds, Knoxville Raceway, Knoxville National.
Yeah, you'll see us up there, so I'm looking forward to it.
All right, Ian Madsen, Mobley, Missouri, give him a big round of applause. A solid run tonight with a big podium finish. And your 2016 defending champion for the Lucas Oil American Sprint Car Series with seven wins on the season. He had been absolutely on fire the last few nights here of Sizzling Summer Speed Week, the 2017 edition. But Sunnyvale Sam, tonight was one of those nights where maybe early you thought you had a car, and then it was all business with your hands full about 10 to 12 laps into that thing.
Yeah, hold on a second. I got to wipe off my hydrator foundation fire system. Brown was class to fill tonight. He did a really smart race. His tires look better than everybody else's. I got to racing with Aaron there when I got by him, and made a stupid mistake, burnt my tires off, pushed them all to hell, and then it allowed Brown to pounce on us there. And he's a really good racer, and for him to come in and beat us like that, I feel like he beat us pretty bad. So. Hats off to their team. They run a really great operation, and definitely envious of what they have over there. But we're trying to build our team like that, one piece at a time. But I can't say enough for my guys. They worked really hard today, and they worked hard all week. And I got to thank Keith for coming out, relieving the truck driver duties for me. I was a lot more rested today than I was last night, and that's a big deal in this game.
In the win column, and a solid speed week, the finale coming up tomorrow night in Wheatland. Up to this point, you've got to be real thrilled with it.
I wouldn't say thrilled at all. Those two DNFs at the beginning of the week, and then last night getting chopped there late, and running 15th, it doesn't really look good. We got a couple bright spots on the radar with the first and the second. So anytime we actually finish a race, we run first or second. If we don't finish, we're at 15th or 17th or something like that.
Well, welcome to Mobley, Missouri. We'll see you down the road tomorrow night at the Lucas Oil Speedway, and we'll be watching for that finale tomorrow night.
One last thing to say, definitely got to give the track major props. Thanks for getting that model worked in for us, and that was major to the racing tonight. Put on a hell of a show for you fans, and that's what we're out here for.
give this young man and the rest of the competitors one more big round of applause. Randolph County Raceway, thank you guys so much for coming out tonight. Brian, we'll send it back up to you, Scott.